Hello, good morning, everybody. How are you doing today? Sana okay pa rin po tayo and feeling sane with the home quarantine thing. And this is our new normal, but we also have our fears na hindi po natin maiiwasan. But why is fear more dangerous than COVID-19 itself? Of course, we are fearful, we're scared of our lives and of our families, and that's why we stay home when we are ordered to stay home. But why is it more dangerous if we are more fearful of our lives than, getting the disease itself? Because studies show that if you are scared, if you are fearful, you will go panic, di ba? Magpapanik ka. Dito lang sa Virginia Beach, especially in the Western countries, nagkakaubusan ng toilet paper. I don't understand bakit yung mga tao nagkakaubusan ng, everywhere I go this time, wala kang mahanap na toilet paper talaga. And that's why when you are scared, when you are fearful, you tend to panic. And when you panic, hindi ka makakapag-isip ng mabuti. Your judgment will be clouded, it will go blurry. So you tend to become selfish as well. So what does it mean to become selfish? So people become selfish is that they don't care. Di bali nang mamatay sila basta mabuhay ka lang. That's what people are thinking kapag ka nasa bingit ng kamatayan or nasa crisis na katulad nitong kinakaharap natin. That's why it's really not good for us to be scared, especially during this time, because we tend to become more we become to become we tend to become more selfish, and gusto nating tayo lang ang masasalba. We don't care about other people anymore, which is not bad. Hindi naman ganoon ang humanity, di ba? Kailangan we have to help one another, especially what's going on in the Philippines right now. Nagkakagulo doon sa Twitter at nagkaka-word war at ginagawang battleground itong social media because of, the differences in their political views. But anyway, sana sa panahong ito, crisis should actually bring unity. And it should, on the positive side, instead of being scared, it has to, bring about the best in us instead of the worst in us. So this is an opportunity, actually, yung itong crisis na ito, to show what we've got, to show the best in us instead of lumabas yung pangit. Kailangan ipalabas natin yung maganda. But because of fear, hindi nga po tayo nakakapag-isip ng mabuti. But anyway, share your thoughts and views, and who knows, we can talk about this. We'll expound this topic a little longer in the next live session. Okay. Anyway, so fear is very dangerous because when we are scared, the part of our brain, amygdala, it actually releases cortisol, and then when we have too much cortisol, it creates anxiety. So nasi-stress po tayo. So when we get stressed, our immune system weakens, and our immune system is our line of defense. Our antibodies kumukonte para depensahan ang sarili natin sa sakit, especially against COVID-19. And if we have weak immune system, that means mas madali tayong nagkakasakit. And that is why those people na may mga sakit, hindi nila alam na may sakit sila, and then nagpa-check sila sa doktor, they found out na, they have this so and so, illness or disease, and then they get worried, they get anxious, mas madali silang nagde-deteriorate yung kanilang health. So instead of worrying, why don't we just look at the positive side, the brighter side? We make connections with our loved ones. This is an opportunity, actually, to stay home and to be connected with our families, and not just be connected physically with our families whom we are living with. We can actually keep in touch with the people who are away out there, nasa abroad or nasa ibang country or ibang city or ibang probinsya, ganon. We can reach out to them, especially kung nasa bahay lang tayo. This is a great opportunity for us to talk to them, di ba? So sana tayong lahat, huwag tayong maging scared. Ayan, huwag tayong matakot, because God is bigger than this. God is bigger than this COVID-19, although it drives the rest of the world crazy. But always remember that God is in control, and God is bigger than this. And the Bible said, God did not give us the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and of sound mind. What does that sound mind mean? Sound mind means peace of mind. And as the Bible again said, if you look up to God, God will give us the peace, not as the world gives, but only God or Jesus can give. So that's what we need is just God, because no one is in control. There's no cure to COVID-19 at this time. Wala pa pong gamot. At, you know, there's no vaccine. There's nothing that can fight this. There's no antidote to this. Pero meron tayong God who is bigger than all of this. And He is only in control. And if the solution is not on earth, definitely we have to look beyond earth. We have to look beyond the supernatural power of God to cover us and to protect us. Because there's no such, you know, there's nothing is available yet, but God is available 24/7. Every day of our lives, He's always there. So all we have to do is ask and we shall receive, and knock and we shall find. Ganun lang po, mga friends. So let's encourage one another to stay positive in this time of crisis. And according to Dr. Miles Monroe, I was listening to his teaching last night. He said that crisis should bring about, you know, the best in us instead of, you know, the worst in us. Well, the best thing that could happen in times of crisis is unity. We become united, you know. Yung mga taong matulungin, mas magiging matulungin at this time. Because, you know, makikita ngayon, sa panahon ngayon, and when there is pressure, when there is stress, when there is a need, and the person is matulungin, matutulong siya. He or she will be proactive to do his part. And I think that's what we need at this time, is to do our part. You know, pag sinabing, stay home na, huwag matikas ang ulo. Diba? It will not only save your lives, it will save the rest of your families, your friends, your neighborhood, your co-workers. If you're feeling sick, if you also already have that symptoms, huwag mo nang hintayin na pagsabihan ka na umuwi ka at, you know, isolate yourself or quarantine yourself. You know, as a responsible human being or citizen, you gotta do what you have to do, you know, without being told. You gotta do it yourself. So, para naman sa, especially sa lahat ng mga ating mga, you know, mga kababayan Pilipino, nasaan man kayo sa mundo, you know, we have to do our part. Mas makabubuti pong huwag na natin sisihin yung ibang tao sa mga, you know, may mga kanya-kanyang trabaho kasi tayo. So yung mga government, hayaan natin gawin yung trabaho nila. At bilang citizens and private citizens, mamamayang Pilipino, and in my case, I'm in the US, you know, when the governor said, you know, you have to stay home, that this mandate, and, you know, you will be fined $2,500 if you're caught, you know, gallivanting everywhere. For no reason, if you have no essential business outside, and then nakikita kang umakalat-kalat dyan sa daan, so you will be fined $2,500. So, sana sa Pilipinas ganun din, but of course, the Philippines is different, pero meron din tayong part na magagawa natin. You know, we have to save ourselves and our community, our barangay, especially sa Pilipinas, dikit-dikit doon. So, mag-iingat tayo, we'll just have to do our part, dahil itong lahat ng ito lilipas din, at mas madaling lumipas ito, if we do our part, diba? So we should not fear, because, you know, fear will just make everything worse. It weakens our immune system, number one. And of course, it creates panic. It creates chaos. It makes us more selfish. So if you are selfish, di bali na magkaubusan, uubusin mo. Para sa'yo, para sa pamilya mo, di baling mawalan sila, di baling mamatay yung iba basta't mabuhay ka. That is, you know, the mentality of the people in times of crisis. Kasi gusto mong mauna, kasi ayaw mo maubusan ka, parang ganon. But instead, you know, instead of saving your life, you're endangering the whole community. It's because sana masasalba mo sila, pero hinord mo lahat. So, ikaw lang masasalba. Paano kung ikaw lang sa mundo, di ba? Hindi ka rin mabubuhay kung ikaw lang sa mundo. Walang kalatoy-latoy ang world kung ikaw lang mag-isa. Diba? So we have to share the resources of the community, of the country, of the world to other people. Kasi yung mga selfish talaga, mas nauuna pang namatay yan. Kasi, you know, pagka nagkagulo-gulo, sila ang pinakaunang itatapon doon sa kung saan man sila nararapat itapon. Kasi nga, wala silang silbi. You know, but people who share, people who extend their help to other people, mas pinahahalagahan sila ng mga tao, especially during this time. So, sana naman sa panahon ngayon, maalala tayo ng tao, ng kapitbahay natin, na isang nila lang na may puso na tumutulong sa kanilang kapwa, you know, kapwa, kabarangay, or, you know, co-worker or something like that. So, being afraid or being scared is actually, you're more susceptible to getting sick. Why? Because you worry a lot, you stress a lot, and, you know, you panic, aligaga ka, hindi ka mapakali, and then, you know, sa sobra mong takot, natatakot ka na magbigay, natatakot ka na maging tao, natatakot ka nga maging normal. It's because feeling mo it's already the end of the world, but it will be the end of the world if you will continue to be scared, especially if you will endanger the lives of the people around you kasi hoarder ka. Instead na pamahagi mo yung pagkain, especially just sa mga barangay sa Pilipinas, yung, you know, kung, I don't know, but, you know, I've been seeing a lot of posts in social media na hindi maganda yung the way they distribute those rasyon. So, sana naman, huwag nang kurakutin yan. Eh, nagugutom na nga lahat ng mga tao, kukurakutin pa. Maawa naman po kayo. Tsaka sa lahat ng mga politiko, this is the best time para magpakita ang gilas kayo ngayong nahihirapan at ngayong talaga kaya kailangan ng mga tao yung pagkain. Diba? Kailangan i-distribute talaga yan. Eh, tingnan mo yung mga mayayaman dyan sa Pilipinas, nagtatago, natatakot. Natatakot sila na mag-expose sa mga sarili nila kasi natatakot sila magkaroon ng virus. But, you know, if you protect yourself properly and, you know, you distance yourself properly, kaya nga meron tayong sinatawag na social distancing. So, if you just do the proper way to protect yourself or, you know, wear the PPEs or, you know, you do the precautionary measures para maiwasan itong sakit na ito, and then you're most definitely, you know, okay. Pero, you know, pero yung pagiging selfish mo ay nakakapirwisyo at nakakapag nakakalagay sa alanganin sa buhay ng iba. So sana instead na this situation will bring out the worst, it will show and manifest the best in you. So sana maging instrument of hope and will brighten up other people's lives by our words of encouragement, our means, you know, our messages of comfort. Yung nga sinasabi ko last time, just at least, you know, say hi to the person, even if that person is not next to you, kahit na malayo sila, mag-message lang po tayo, okay na po yun sa kanila. At saka, minsan nakakatulong din yung huwag tayong manood ng TV lagi because we always see that bad news na nakikita lang natin lagi yung, you know, yung mga kung ilang bilang ng patay or all those, you know, yung fatalities at yung mga positive and all of that. So why don't we, you know, look to God and, you know, think about the things na kailangan mong pasalamatan at this time, you know, because there are a lot of things that we can see na marirealize natin na we are still very blessed instead of, you know, mag-worry tayo sa kung anumang mga nangyayari. Of course, hindi mo maiiwasan na may mga gutom, may mga natatakot na mawala ng trabaho, but, you know, nandito na tayo, you know, crisis will actually eventually lead to change or something better. It will revolutionize the way we think, the way we live, and all of that. So, wag muna natin problemahin yung wala. Problemahin naman lang muna natin yung day-to-day. Kasi, you know, the Bible said, tomorrow has a problem of its own. So, kung ano man yung meron tayo ngayon, yun dun tayo magpo-focus. And of course, we have to thank God that we are still alive. And that very thing na buhay pa rin tayo, ingatan natin po yung buhay natin. So, if we have the capacity, kung meron po tayong kakayahan na tumulong at magbigay ng encouragement, kahit na hindi mo makapagbigay ng bigas, pero kahit makapagbigay ka lang man ng words of encouragement at ng positive vibes sa isang tao, makakatulong na rin po yun para mamaboost ang immune system ng isang tao. Kasi happiness, sabi nila, is or laughter or happiness is the best medicine. So, pag magandang pananaw mo sa buhay, maganda ang you know, maganda ang lagay ng iyong puso at isip, 'di ba? So, feeling brave is actually very easy. Sabi ng isang, you know, doctor, what's the name of that doctor? Sabi niya is easy. All you have to do is just provide someone a food for thought, you know, an emotional boost of positivity, ganon. So, you know, you comfort the ones you love, hug the ones you love, you know, but just make sure that when you hug or, you know, when you get close to someone is you're not sick or something. So you've never been outside, you know, you still have to practice social distancing. But, you know, you have to imagine a beautiful future, a beautiful scenario, you know. Huwag kang mag-imagine ng mga doom or gloom or danger or something like that because that will drive you crazy. So anxiety, stress, depression, and all of that, we are prone, especially this time. So kailangan pangalagaan po natin not just our physical bodies but also our mental state. Kasi yung ating ang ating isip, you know, it will actually give us that feeling. And that feeling will also push us to feel something physically. And that's why if you're worried, if you're stressed, if you're anxious, ayan, yung parang aligaga ka, you're physically, you're weak, at you know, hindi mo alam ang gagawin mo. So you will be prone to more danger if hindi mo alam ang ginagawa mo, if hindi ka aware sa environment mo, if hindi maganda ang pananaw mo sa buhay, ibig sabihin magiging pangit din yung magiging actions mo. So instead of, you know, focusing on the negative effects of coronavirus, there are a lot of positive things that this situation is, you know, as an effect to all our lives. For me personally, it makes me more thankful, you know, that I am home. I am with my family. You know, nakakapagod lang. I always post that na nakakapagod na mag-homeschool, mag-work from home, magluto, maglaba, and all of that. So kaya, I said na, I have to make my life normal pa rin. So I go live because this is something that makes me complete. Alam mo yun, you express yourself because this is, you know, my form of expression. Self-expression. So, ginagawa ko to, it's because it makes me feel normal. Because hindi nga ako makalabas. So, whatever makes you feel normal, whatever makes you feel happy, whatever makes you strong, do that. Sa panahon ngayon, kailangan natin gumawa ng mga bagay-bagay na alam natin makakapagpalakas sa atin because we know ourselves better than anyone else. So, do whatever you think is best for you, especially this time, especially for mothers who are taking care of their families. Kailangan natin maghanap ng paraan para mapalakas yung ating mga sarili because we can never take care of our families if we ourselves are weak. So, we have to be the first person to show that strength, especially to our families. So, this is just a thought for others to think, you know, an idea for you. You know, we actually have a lot more power over our feelings than we think, because what we think produces feelings. You know, as I have said earlier, what we think produces feelings, and our feelings will actually create the action. So it's just like your emotion is actually what's triggering you to, you know, to feel something physically. So if you are worried and stressed and, you know, you feel like you're tired and everything, like it's the end of the world, so syempre magiging weak ka, you know, and when you're weak and when you're tired, your immune system will go down. So you don't want that to happen because you will be the prime target at madaling ma-infect ng sakit, and you don't want that to happen to you. So always activate your brain, make it always, you know, always make your brain, you know, think positive and attract only positive thoughts, and so it will radiate. Also your feelings and your actions will manifest, you know, the best positive thoughts you could ever have. Anyway, ayan. Hi Michael, Peter, laban lang talaga, ayan. And thank you very much po sa lahat ng mga, you know, who were with me today, and I will try as much as possible to do this as frequent as, you know, as I can. As I want to be consistent with my Facebook Live and all of that. So I just want to wish you all, you know, the best of health, and may God always protect you, protect us. We just have to do our part. You know, we will be confident na hindi tayo magkakasakit. We will be confident na hindi tayo mapapahamak. We will be confident that our family will be provided and protected and will be safe, not just our families, but also we have to, you know, to pray for our communities. We also have to pray for our barangay, our leaders, you know, instead of, you know, bashing them and doing this or that. We have to let them do their part as we do our part also. Huwag tayong marinisi sa ibang, bakit ganito ganyan? But why? Have you done your part? You know, you have to ask yourself that. We have, instead of being reactive, why don't we be proactive, you know, especially sa mga maliliit na mga lugar o mga probinsya or barangay. Let's do our part. Pag sinabing huwag kang lumabas, huwag ka nang lumabas. Kung alam mong tama, gawin mo na lang. Huwag ka nang magreklamo, you know. So, kung may mga gagawin man silang mali nila yan, masisisi sila in the future. Kung ikaw naman ay may maling ginawa, huwag mong sisihin sa iba. Kasi especially kung pinagsabihan ka na, at wala kang ginawa, ay buti nga sa'yo kung may mangyari sa'yo, di ba? Ang tigas ng ulo mo. But anyway, I just wish everyone, you know, a happy and a safe life. And sana po tayong lahat ay manatiling positive, you know, because our positivity will bring light. And it will actually encourage other people to adopt the same view as what you have, you know. Kailangan lang natin i-practice ang ating ang ating pagiging positibo sa buhay. Kailangan natin yun, especially sa panahon ngayon. Kailangan natin magtulungan, kailangan natin magbigay ng laughter and cheer and hope, especially that faith. Ayan, always remember, God did not give us the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and of sound mind. And it's very important this time to have sound mind kasi maloloka po talaga tayo kung hindi maganda ang laman ng ating puso at isipan. At laging natandaan, kung saan natin bumuti ang ating magiging buhay, pagbutihin muna natin, natin i-improve yung ating mga sarili. We have to begin out within ourselves, from within ourselves. So, sa bahay po natin, practice good hygiene, magbugas ng kamay, at laging i-observe po natin yung social distancing kung saan-saan man po tayo. Huwag tayong pakalat-kalat sa daan kung wala naman po tayong mahahalagang sadya, especially kung hindi naman pagkain ang sadya natin. You know, bawal ang kiat, bawal ang biga-biga sa panahon karon, nga krisis ang panahon. This has been Dear Monica. I wish you all the best and may God protect you and bless you. Hanggang